7 News at 10 on CW56. Winter? What winter? Record-breaking temperatures in New England.
A female clerk clocked in the face. It's the video police are hoping closes the case of a wanted felon.
A fisherman hooks a piece of history. The rare relic raised from the sea. Winds wreck the southeast and turn parked cars into a pileup. A young life saved. And a week of heroes in the Big Apple. Plus, on the trail of a pant-pilfering perp.
I gave my pants.
The night team's got a full hour of news.
7 News at 10 on CW56 starts now.
Live from the news station, this is 7 News at 10.
So where's winter? New England smack dab in the middle of record-breaking warmth. Windsurfers, joggers, you name it, everyone's enjoying it. Not too many complaints. As we take a live look outside tonight, cloudy and damp, but that could change in the coming hours. Good evening. Really an unbelievable stretch of warm winter weather.
And oh yeah, it looks like it could climb even higher tomorrow. Let's get right to Chief Meteorologist Pete Bouchard. Pete, could we break 65 degrees tomorrow?
I think it's a possibility, Matt. Yeah, getting mid-60s, no problem, especially if the sun comes out. Today we were 63 in Boston. We did break a record, that old record set back not long ago, 1993. In Worcester, we were a degree shy. We tried as hard as we could. 57 and 58 was the record set back in 1957. It's been so mild as of late, 28 days straight above normal temperatures in Worcester and 27 of 28 in Boston, that the trees are beginning to bud. This is the picture in Jamaica Plain with this flowering plum here. So what's in store? We have more mild air coming up for tomorrow. I expect the temperatures only to fall back into the lower to mid-50s tonight. We're 56 degrees now in Boston, 58 in Bedford, 57 in Worcester, right at the high temperature for the day, 59 Beverly. A couple of showers to be found out there. Not much in the way of water tonight, but this is a new warm front moving in, and it will bring those temperatures right up tomorrow. We'll be talking more records in just a minute.
7 News now with some scary moments for bus riders in Boston. Dozens on board a T-bus when fire breaks out and the passengers scramble to safety. Some real Hot Wheels here, and tonight investigators are trying to figure out how it all started. The night team's Linda Ergus live with details for us. Linda?
Matt, this whole thing went down just after 7 this morning. The bus had actually just made a pickup right over there, and boy, did this ordeal wake up some passengers.
This is a picture taken from a camera phone. You can see in the distance the MBTA bus and the billowing smoke. Here's another shot. You can see here the white smoke is coming from the back of the bus. And on board, there's about 40 passengers. The pictures taken by this man, Roger Roderick, who had just gotten picked up.
Sound like a huge gunshot.
Sky 7 above the bus after the fire was put out. You can see investigators looking things over very carefully. Roger says he had barely sat down when something exploded and the panic erupted.
That's crazy. People trying to run to each exit.
But they wouldn't open. John Perry was also on board. He says people were actually forced to jump through the windows.
Everybody scrambling, trying to get off. Bus driver stated, open the windows.
Even after everyone escaped, there was still quite a sight. No doubt the ordeal caused quite a scare.
I would say for 45 seconds, there was no way to get off the bus.
Now, the MBTA says it is still investigating. They do not know what caused that explosion. Fortunately, no one was hurt. We're live in Boston tonight. Linda Ergus, 7 News 19.
We're following a developing story now in Roxbury. A 21-year-old woman is seriously hurt after she was hit by a car and dragged more than 60 feet. It happened on Tremont Street. The driver stayed on that scene after hitting the woman. The woman was walking with a group of people when she was hit. Police say she was actually underneath the car the whole time. She's now at Boston Medical Center in critical condition.
Health officials say dozens could be at risk after a meningitis scare in 3 New England states. 21-year-old UNH student Danielle Thompson died from meningitis Wednesday. She'd been in Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts 10 days before she was admitted to a hospital. Health officials have already identified about 80 people who came in contact with her. Those most at risk would be people who shared food or beverages or share the same utensils. In Rhode Island, 20,000 students had the day off. Their schools are closed as health experts look into a string of encephalitis cases. A few weeks ago, an elementary school student died from encephalitis. And health officials are looking into whether there's a connection between that illness and a separate case of meningitis.
New at 10, a robber grabbed some dough at a Dunkin' Donuts, but not before, watch this, throwing a few punches at that clerk right there. The crime, as you can see, all caught on camera. And the Night Team's Ann Allred is live with a search for the robber. Ann?
Matt, police are calling this suspect dangerous, desperate, and unpredictable. They wouldn't tell us how much money he got away with, but they suspect he's probably a drug addict looking for quick cash and a quick fix. And he could probably strike again.
The robber reached for the cash, then bam, he puts his fist in the female clerk's face.
It made me angry to see someone assault a woman like that.
Police releasing this video because the assault and robbery is still unsolved. It happened here at this Dunkin' Donuts in Rockland about 6 weeks ago. The victim, not wanting her face on camera, said she never saw it coming.
Very fast, I can't remember. Very fast, just touch my face and take the money, it's gone. You know?
Were you hurt badly?
Yeah, I'm bad, okay.
Her head jolted back after being struck in the face, and her hat fell off onto the floor.
And while she's made a full recovery, it's a beating police say is so violent because it was so unnecessary. You can see the robber walk up to the counter, grabbing a bottle of water as a decoy. He pays for it to get the register open, gets his hands on the cash, yet still goes in for the punch.
She's helpless. She's not, she opened the cash register. She's not any threat to him. And yet he resorts to violence.
Violence, police say this suspected teen needs to pay for.
It's the fright in her face when you see the video that, you know, she's just kind of stunned.
And here's what we have on the suspect, a white male between 16 and 19 years old, between 5'4" and 5'6". Thin build, and he was wearing a UMass shirt and a white baseball cap. Call Rockland Police. We're live in Rockland. I'm Ann Allred, 7 News 19.
Pittsburgh couple facing a slew of charges after causing some serious trouble. Antonio Ramos and Brenda McPherson, both of Pittsburgh, appeared in court. Police say their adventures began just before 11 a.m. yesterday. They jumped into a Pittsburgh man's SUV and threatened him at knife point, police
said.
They
put the knife right on the neck, and he pulled me down like this and put a knife. He said, he's going to cut my throat. He's going to kill me.
Now, the couple allegedly took the stolen SUV in a joyride, going at speeds of around 90 miles per hour after doing some shoplifting. Their fun ended when they crashed right into this building. They were taken into custody soon after. Now the pair faces multiple charges, including carjacking.
The speaker has been sentenced. A man who used to be one of the most powerful politicians here in this state can't run for office after making some embarrassing admissions. The Night Team's Dan Housley, live with more. Dan?
Well, we are now talking about some kind of small political hack trying to get out of a jail sentence. We're talking about a man, as you said, considered by some at one point the most powerful political force in this state. But after appearing here in federal court, he can't even run for dog catcher.
How's it feel to be a convicted felon?
Tom Finneran leaves the federal courthouse in shame. It wasn't long ago they called him King Tom, then House Speaker Tom Finneran, in some ways more powerful than the governor. But then Finneran lied about his role in a controversial redistricting plan and now pleaded guilty to obstruction of justice.
I acknowledge clearly and without any hesitation my errors in judgment concerning my conduct in court on that day. I am sorry. I am truly sorry.
Finneran cut a deal to avoid perjury charges and possible jail time, instead accepting 18 months probation and a $25,000 fine. About 100 of Finneran's friends, family, and political colleagues joined the disgraced former speaker to show their support.
We all make mistakes. We're all human.
I think he made an error in judgment. I'm glad in the courtroom that it was clear that, you know, there was no racial intent.
While he stayed out of jail, Finneran could lose his law license and maybe his $500,000-a-year job as president of the Mass Biotech Council.
The wound I have inflicted on myself will be with me and will hurt for the rest of my life.
And speaking of job prospects, it's been rumored that Finneran is in the running for a big talk show host job at a local radio station. It's not clear whether this kind of notoriety would make him more or less likely to get that kind of job. We're live outside the federal courthouse in South Boston. Dan Housley, 7 News 19.
After a whirlwind inauguration day, it is time for Deval Patrick to get down to business. The Commonwealth's new governor spending his first day prioritizing with his cabinet before going to Andover in the first of 5 weekend receptions. The governor says the state is looking at a budget deficit of at least $1 billion. He places the blame on the Romney administration for trying to patch together solutions to a big budget shortfall.
I want to make sure that the government is organized in a way that enables us to drive the agenda we were elected to drive.
Patrick has given his cabinet 30 days to file a progress report for each of their organizations.
New at 10, a cruel crime on the Cape. The head of a dog found on the hood of a car. The Night Team's Ryan Schulteis live in Falmouth where it happened. Ryan.
And Matt, this is one of those stories where you simply shake your head and wonder how someone could do this to an innocent animal. That head was found right at this apartment complex Thursday morning. I want to warn you, some of the images you're about to see are quite, quite disturbing. The pictures are tough to look at.
It's disgusting and it's cruel.
It's the decapitated head of a pit bull. Someone killed this dog and then put its head in this popcorn tin and left it on top of a woman's car. Because the images are so graphic, we chose to only show a few select pictures.
That's sick, man. It is. That's gross.
It was a pit bull?
Yeah.
My God. That's horrible.
The Falmouth Department of Natural Resources says the head was discovered here at the Gosnold Grove Apartments early Thursday morning. The dog head was identified by a homeless woman as her pit bull named Nitros. Officers from the Falmouth DNR and a handful of other law enforcement agencies executed a search warrant at this Mashpee facility called Notorious Blue Kennels. The DNR will not say why they're focusing their investigation at this kennel or what the connection is to the pit bull head. They do tell us they have some good leads in this case and they hope to have some action very soon. If you have any information about this disturbing discovery, you're asked to call the Falmouth DNR right away. We're live in East Falmouth. Ryan Schulteis, 7 News 19.
Wicked weather strikes in the south. A string of tornadoes killed 2 people, leaving crumpled cars and devastation in their wake. And scenes like this one stretch all the way from Louisiana to South Carolina. Twisters raged in Louisiana, where at least 2 people were killed and 15 others were hurt and taken to the hospital. This woman could have been one of them.
And I think reading my Bible helped. It would save me. And when I ran with my Bible in my hand to the hall, I think that's what saved me. Otherwise, where I was laying down, the bedspread kept coming up, and I think if I would have been there, the roof split open inside, it would have picked me up.
The same could have happened to people in parts of Georgia, where whipping winds did this. A home looks like a dollhouse with the roof completely peeled off. The rest of the neighborhood littered with debris. In Mississippi, it's a wonder no one was killed, with homes torn apart and trees leveled, cars tossed. From this blast of unrelenting weather, at least 9 people were injured. If it wasn't twisters leveling homes, it was the strong winds causing all kinds of destruction in South Carolina, flipping cars outside an elementary school where 15 people were hurt. A state of emergency has been declared in some of these areas, and it's not even certain if all the damage was in fact caused by tornadoes.
President Bush making some military changes. It comes just days before his highly anticipated speech on Iraq. The president is set to unveil his new policy as early as Wednesday. Today, the White House announced a staff shakeup that replaces the top generals in Iraq and the Middle East. Neither was comfortable with sending more troops abroad. In addition, the president demoted Director of National Intelligence John Negroponte to Deputy Secretary of State. His nomination for a replacement, retired Navy Admiral Mike McConnell. Both positions require the Senate's approval by the new Congress controlled by Democrats. A hobbling Arnold Schwarzenegger was sworn in for a second term as California's governor. Nursing a broken right leg, Schwarzenegger missed the first part of the ceremony in Sacramento, but he came out on crutches, as you can see, to take the oath of office and deliver a speech. The governor told the crowd, California is a special state.
The world knows our name. We are a good and global commonwealth. Yes, we have problems that must be solved, but it remains true. What a prosperous, peaceful Golden State in which we live, work, and raise our families.
After he was sworn in, Schwarzenegger declared himself a political centrist, saying he would not be held captive by either the left or the right.
It is the night before the opening games of the NFL playoffs.
We are pumped up. This is going to be good. The Patriots getting set to host the Jets. The head coaches will renew their not-so-friendly rivalry. The Night Team's Dave Briggs is here with more, Dave.
Yeah, guys, Bill Belichick, he's no stranger to losing assistant coaches like Romeo Crennel, nor playing against one-time understudies such as Nick Saban. But when Eric Mangini departed for New York, the already chilly rivalry with the Jets grew suddenly ice cold. The relationship hit a boiling point back in September with the now infamous hug, or handshake, whatever you want to call that thing. That was then. Now the two have split their season series, and the so-called ice war appears to have thawed a bit, with Bill Belichick going so far as to actually acknowledge his counterpart.
You know, I think they've got a good football team. That's obvious. So I think, you know, there are a lot of people that play a part in it. Obviously, Eric's done a good job. The staff's done a good job. Players have played well. I think there's plenty of credit to go around down there. You know, we're 10-6, won 6 of the last 8, won all 3 division games on the road. So, you know, it's pretty good.
My thoughts are exactly the same as they've been, Hutch. You know, for the first 2 games, my approach is no different. My feelings are no different, and I respect and appreciate all the things that he's done for me throughout the course of my career, and that's never going to change.
According to the old odds makers, Belichick-Mangini round 3 is a no contest, though. The Patriots are an 8.5-point favorite in Sunday's game. Much more coming up in sports. In the newsroom, Dave Briggs, 7 News 19.
All right, Dave, thanks. Straight ahead from the 19.
Digging up more than just the catch of the day.
Fishing for answers after a mysterious discovery off New England shores.
Caught on camera, a routine run-in with police spins out of control.
A toddler dangling several stories up and a pair of heroes racing into action.
Forever young, a couple takes drastic steps to stunt their child's growth.
Give me your pants or else. The bizarre stick-ups catching people with their pants down.
And harmless ride or dangerous driving, the dangerous trend popping up on websites.
We're back in 2.
It's almost over, Shreve Crump & Lowe's spectacular reorganization sale. There's still a gigantic selection remaining. Shreve's must dispose of all this inventory immediately. We've taken even greater reductions one final time. Diamonds, precious gems, fine jewelry, and giftware are now 40 to 60% off original ticketed prices. Save on famous brand Swiss watches too, now 30 to 40% off. Don't miss this opportunity to take advantage of Shreve's final reductions. This is one sale you can't afford to miss.
A remarkable 60 miles per gallon. Smile. You could save up to 325 gallons of fuel per smile. Year. And you could be eligible for a federal tax credit.
Smile.
Think about the savings and smile.
Prius saves a lot more than just money. Smile. Prius. So many reasons to smile.
Think about the savings.
Ask someone you know who drives one. Toyota. Moving forward.
Waking up at 3 a.m. with a high fever and chills can make you nervous. At BMC HealthNet Plan Commonwealth Care, we've got a plan for that. Members can call our free 24-hour nurse advice line, get health information, and get help with a doctor's appointment. No health insurance? We've got a plan for that. Choose BMC HealthNet Plan. Call 1-800-792-4355.
Event. Right now, treat your home to fresh new looks, all at savings that are a treat themselves, and live the life without paying the price, only at Home Goods.
Save 65% on a beautiful selection of furs, including mink, fox, beaver, fur trim, leather, and more, during our one-day fur sale in the Fur Vault, available at Macy's.
There's a new 10 o'clock news in town on CW56. A mammoth find off the coast of Maine. A fisherman reels in this ancient artifact. Now, archaeologists want to know if it's a true blast from the past.
That fisherman was hunting for scallops,
but stumbled on something much harder to find. It happened off the coast of Maine near George's Bank. The 19 Sirbani Banerjee is live with more on the ancient discovery. Sirbani?
Well, Francis, the boat left from a marina here in New Bedford and headed for George's Bank off the coast of Maine. That is where they made what you could definitely call a mammoth catch.
It may be covered in barnacles and chiseled by ocean waters, but when this got dredged up in a scallop net, the fisherman who found it off the coast of Maine thought one thing.
Thought it was a woolly end of a woolly mammoth tusk.
Could this be the tip of a tusk from a woolly mammoth, those huge hairy elephants that once lumbered across the ice age?
Cape Cod didn't exist 16, 17,000 years ago. There was a giant tongue of a glacier that covered all of New England.
Among the ancient skeletons at the Harvard Museum of Natural History, yes, that's a giant sloth, is this mastodon, which is very similar to a woolly mammoth.
A lot of people actually have the wrong idea of just how big a mammoth or mastodon really was. They were about the same size as the modern day Indian elephant, but take a look at the tusk, still pretty big. And apparently the tusk found in Maine was even bigger than that one.
I've seen whale ribs before and stuff, and they look a lot different.
Tim Winchenbach and his wife Michelle are sure that what was netted by the Celtic fishing vessel out of New Bedford is an ancient tusk.
Just the thought that, you know, I've held something that's potentially 10,000 years old or older, I find it really fascinating.
The discovery leaving many marveling.
Strange that a couple thousand years ago, one of those gigantic beasts was walking around where your house was.
So just when were those gigantic beasts wandering around? They roamed the earth some 1.5 million years ago. Woolly mammoths died out 10,000 years ago. Right now, museum officials in Maine are looking at pictures of that tusk to determine if, in fact, it really did come from a mammoth. Live in New Bedford, I'm Sorbani Banerjee, 7 News 19.
Off the satellites tonight, two Michigan police officers face justice for a brutal show of force during an arrest. Dash cam video rolls as one officer pushes the man onto the ground. Another officer then kicks the man while he's handcuffed. That driver had a suspended license and an open alcohol container. The arresting officer was suspended and put on probation. The other officer was fired.
You know what? It's not raining in Philly, but take a look. The city's all wet. A broken main left one neighborhood under more than a foot of water this afternoon. Police had to close off the street while that break was fixed. Construction crew was working nearby when the pipe burst, but it's unclear if there's any connection.
The tables turned for an Ohio mother and her teenage son accused of stealing a snake when they return to the pet store. In this video, you can see the pair stealing the 30-inch boa. They thought they got away with their crime, but store clerks and police watched that video. So when the pair came back the following day asking how to take care of the snake, guess what? They were recognized by employees who called police.
Also on 7, a week of heroes in New York. Flames force a toddler to make a leap of faith.
Pray to God we make a catch.
Right into the hands of two men, just days after the actions of a courageous commuter. It's the season of saving.
That toddler caught in the heroic act. Two good Samaritans in the right place at the right time.
Coming to do that?
This little guy is alive today because his Bronx neighbors made a catch worthy of those pinstripers from the same neighborhood.
We don't feel like heroes. We just feel like normal people. Like, that's all we are, normal people.
Julio Gonzalez and his friend saved a 3-year-old boy who dangled by his fingertips from a 4th-floor fire escape. The boy's babysitter had apparently gone into another room to smoke.
All she told me was I was in the bathroom for a second.
All we could do was stay down there and wait till the kid fall down, so then we could pray to God we make a catch.
3-year-old Timothy Otto was treated and released at a local hospital, and the city had another hero story to celebrate. Just hours after, Mayor Bloomberg had given Subway Savior Wesley Autry a medal and a year's worth of free subway rides.
What I did is something that any and every New Yorker should do.
Autry saved a young man having a seizure by diving into a subway pit, covering the man with Massachusetts ties on the tracks as the train passed right over them. As for that 3-year-old, his parents are expressing their thanks to the quick-thinking and sure-handed strangers.
If anybody would get that chance, I think you would do it. Anybody would do the same thing.
It actually took both of the men to keep that boy from hitting the pavement. He has a bandage on his head. I'm sure you saw it, but he's expected to be just fine.
And still to come here from the 19, the extreme steps parents are taking to keep their disabled girl forever young.
Also, a sci-fi spectacle critics are calling one of the best films in months. But do movie buffs agree? Get their take in tonight's Real Review.
Plus, the new diet wonder that is cutting plump pooches down to size.
Hi, everybody. We hope you're having a great warm weekend. We'll see you Monday morning right here on 7.
He's now the former governor of Massachusetts, Mitt Romney. He's looking to the White House and raising money for a presidential run.
Great pitch.
Heading to the movies, can Ben Stiller keep his Night at the Museum number one at the box office for a third week in a row? We'll check the numbers.
Guess who's coming back this week?
Winter.
Jack Frost.
Jack Frost, winter, you name it. We're talking about much colder and maybe some snow this week.
Uh-oh.
You want to tune in Monday morning.
Bum, 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 bum.
We'll see you Monday morning on 7 News Today in New England.
Bright and early, we begin at 5 a.m.
What are you doing?
Oh, you'll see, my friend.
Why is everybody talking?
Kids say all kinds of crap.
About Friends.
I'm gonna be on TV.
They've been on for years. So why all the buzz?
Monica was getting a boob job.
Here's a hint.
We've never slept with you.
And whose fault is that?
Things are getting friendlier.
You tricked me to get me into bed?
That's right.
I feel so used.
On Friends.
If I enjoy this, you have only yourself to blame.
Friends, weeknights on New England CW 56.
Even with these unexpected features that come standard on the Toyota Corolla, even with its truly impressive fuel economy, the most compelling reason to buy a new Corolla is an old Corolla.
My 93 Corolla has 126,551 miles.
224,119 miles.
333,670 miles.
There's dependable, and then there's Corolla dependable. Ask someone you know who drives one. Toyota, moving forward.
I kind of needed to do something with my life, and I've always wanted to go into the medical field, and I said, yeah, I'll give it a try.
You could actually accomplish so much in a short period of time.
Great classes, fabulous teachers. That sums it up in a little nutshell.
If she can do it, you can do it. Pick up the phone and call right now and start on the road to a rewarding career and a better life. So call.
Call Bryman Institute for a brochure now at 1-800-828-7179. That's 1-800-828-7179.
Are you picking up the kids?
Well, I thought you were going to a honey butter camp, which means that I'm going to have to cut my day short. I had a lot of errands I had.
Hun? If a call is dropped with a long-winded talker, chances are they haven't noticed this. Drop call etiquette says call the person back immediately. Act like you heard what they said. Then let them continue their conversation. Domination with minimum interference.
Or you could just switch to the network with the fewest dropped calls. Singular, raising the bar. Now buy a Samsung phone and get three free.
An Illinois couple has sparked a national ethical debate. They stunted the growth of their mentally and physically disabled daughter, leaving her, for better or worse, forever young. The 9 Team's Lauren Priswell is here with more on why really the parents are doing it. Lauren?
Frances, at the center of this debate is a 9-year-old known only by her first name, Ashley. She is a little girl who will never grow up, a decision her parents made. These photos of Ashley were made public on her family's website this week when they decided to tell their side of the story. We don't know her last name or who her family is, but we do know that the 9-year-old suffers from a mysterious illness doctors call static encephalopathy. She can't talk, walk, or do anything for herself, and never will. So her parents made the unusual decision to stop her growth, and now biomedical ethicists around the world are weighing in on what appears to be an unprecedented case.
Initially, I was a little startled.
This is entirely new territory.
Doctors at Seattle's Children's Hospital gave her high doses of estrogen, ensured to keep her at 4'5" and about 75 pounds for the rest of her life. And they removed her uterus and breast buds, so she'll never experience menstruation or have a woman's chest. The surgeries were done in 2004, but it wasn't revealed to the public until recently. In their website, her parents say they did it for her long-term comfort.
The parents really saw two choices in front of them. One was to keep their child at home if she remains small, and the other is to have the child hospitalized or institutionalized because they couldn't take care of her anymore.
Ashley's parents are not speaking publicly. Ashley's doctors say without this treatment, she likely would have grown to 5'6" tall, weighing 125 pounds. Live in the newsroom, I'm Lauren Priswell, 7 News 19.
The state of Colorado is in the middle of another winter wallop, the third snowstorm in 3 weeks, dumping another 48 inches on Denver. Forecasters are calling for up to 20 inches in the mountains. The southeast corner of that state will face snowdrifts up to 15 feet. The snowstorm is expected to taper off tonight.
Now, 7 Weather with Chief Meteorologist Pete Bouchard.
Looks pretty good on video, huh? We don't have any of that in our future, that's for sure. Over the next couple of days, at least, especially into this weekend where we may set another record tomorrow. What else is new, right? It's the winter of 06-07. Outside in Boston, the cloud deck is getting lower in the city. 55 degrees is our temperature. Dew point reading 53. Some folks have said it's sticky outside. Not far from the truth, too. Humidity 93%, wind from the south at about 8 miles per hour. The barometer is steady. Heard all about the records earlier in the show. We'll get to those again in a minute. But we have a couple of showers passing by, mostly northwest. Just northwest of Stowe and up towards Lemonster and even up into southern New Hampshire over near Nashua and then over to the seacoast. But in Boston, we just had a couple of sprinkles. That's about it. And I don't expect much more out of this little weather system going by. 55 in town now. Look how mild it is in Plymouth. This is unheard of. Close to 60. It's 10:30 at night here in Bedford. 56, a degree colder than the high temperature, and 2 degrees away from the record still at this hour in Worcester, 58 in Fitchburg, 53 in Hyannis. Some fog is creeping into the picture on the Cape. Look at the mile there going up to Portland and Caribou, Maine. And then down through D.C., it's still 61 degrees, Cincinnati at 59 degrees. Records fell all across the Northeast today around Syracuse, Binghamton, even up to Messina, New York. New York City did not set a record, and neither did Hartford nor did Worcester, but maybe tomorrow. There's always another day, right? So most of the heavy showers going far to our northwest tonight. And look across Vermont and across central New Hampshire. We're going to be seeing these away from Boston. I think, for the most part, that heavy stuff goes across northern New England. And the warm front just wanders through very quietly, sets us up for a pretty warm day tomorrow. Now, the real problem with tomorrow's forecast is how much sun are we going to see? I think it will slowly come out through the course of the day, get it in the afternoon. And I think with that, the temperatures will take off, too. We are close to 70 degrees in some spots come tomorrow afternoon. But then on Sunday, the whole game's over. Not the football game, but it looks like the warm spell, a part of it at least, going from 50s back to 60s. It's not a huge drop, but it's significant enough for you to note. And then clouds move in Sunday afternoon, and especially Sunday night with some rain Sunday night and early Monday. Look at these values tomorrow, though. In Boston, 67 degrees. The record is 62. Gone. 67 in Brockton, maybe close to 70 there. 62 in Worcester, that should break the record of about 58 degrees tomorrow. So if we make 67 tomorrow in Boston, what's that like? Well, that's like mid-May, almost late May weather. We're getting into almost the summertime. Normal high for the 16th of May, 67 degrees. Normal high is actually 37, and we're way above that by 20 degrees or 30 degrees tomorrow. And then Saturday, about 53, 48 on Sunday, and about 37 on Monday. Winter does come back, but it's not really with a vengeance. I just see us getting closer to normal. For the Pats game on Sunday, mild, about 53 degrees at the kickoff. And then by the end of the game, near it, as we take away a victory from the Jets, we'll be about 50 degrees and we'll be overcast by then. Rain should be well after dark, and especially overnight on Sunday. Almost warm tonight, occasional showers, 52 to 56 degrees, pretty light showers though. More records tomorrow, clouds slowly break up, 63 to 70 degrees, and the 7-on-7 forecast. As we go into next week, we get colder, but we also have this, a little feature we call snow. Yeah, there might be a couple of flurries or a snow shower on Wednesday. Doesn't look like a big deal now, reminding you, yeah, that it is January, but it looks like too, we may warm up again late next week. It's amazing stuff. We have a new addition to the weather department. Her name is Dylan Dreyer. She'll be in tomorrow morning starting at 9 on Channel 7.
All right, we'll be watching. Thanks, Pete. It sounds grim, but the world is in its final days.
It is the idea behind one of the most gripping movies in months. We hit the theaters to see what you think of Children of Men in tonight's Real Review. 7's Romeo has the details. Romeo?
Francis, the movie shows a world without hope, people rioting in the streets, really losing their minds. But what would they do if that hope suddenly returned? It's the idea behind Children of Men. It's the year 2027, and the human race can't reproduce. Time is running out for mankind, and things get even worse when the youngest human dies.
He struggled all his life with the celebrity status thrust upon him as the world's youngest person.
Chaos breaks out. Clive Owens, who plays a disillusioned former activist, leads a movement to overthrow the authority. He picks up veteran actor Michael Caine's character, an old friend, and joins forces with Julianne Moore, another leader of the rebellion. Things look bad in the apocalyptic story until Owens' character finds hope for the world, a pregnant woman.
Wait.
And it's up to him to guide her to safety, which takes them on a wild ride. So far, critics love the movie, and so do people in Boston.
That's a good movie.
Yeah, very interesting, very indie thick feel to it.
I liked it. It's a heavy movie.
I thought it had a great aesthetic and a lot to say about contemporary society and politics.
And be prepared to have your thinking caps on when you go to see this movie. The director, Alfonso Cuarón, will have you talking. By the way, you may remember Cuarón from some other big movies, Harry Potter, the latest, and The Prisoner of Azkaban. Children of Men open in select theaters today. Happy Friday, everybody. I'm Romeo, 7 News.
Good resume there. Thanks, Romeo. Ahead from the night team, burning rubber, but take a look. Who's behind the wheel? The dangerous trend that has cameras rolling and police trying to crack down.
A trouser-targeting robber is catching people, yep, with their pants down.
And for the first time since undergoing surgery for testicular cancer, Bruins rookie Phil Kessel returns to the ice tonight. That plus the Celtics running and gunning tonight in Memphis. That's next in sports.
Since you were a child, you've been asked to share and share alike. Since, at heart, you're still a child, we invite you to share and share a love. Four-night packages, including round-trip airfare from Boston, start at only $8.49. Call 1-877-LIBERTY to book.
Cool shoes. Where'd you get them?
Wouldn't you like to know? Like I just hand out trade beauty secrets to cute girls on the elevator. Been having a little bit of trouble with the IRS lately. You know, I look good for my age, okay? As soon as I change my name and my identity, I think it'll be fine. You know, I feel like I know you because I hear everything that goes on in your apartment.
Too much info. Get what you really want in your Verizon Yellow Pages. Now for Boston, Brookline, and Cambridge. Verizon Yellow Pages. Get to it.
It's almost over. Shreve Crump & Lowe's spectacular reorganization sale. There's still a gigantic selection remaining. Shreve's must dispose of all this inventory immediately. We've taken even greater reductions one final time. Diamonds, precious gems, fine jewelry, and giftware are now 40 to 60% off original ticketed prices. Save on famous brand Swiss watches, too. Now 30 to 40% off. Don't miss this opportunity to take advantage of Shreve's final reductions. This is one sale you can't afford to miss.
Bob, I gotta hand it to you. You're the only one with the guts to put the product and the price out for all to see, including your competitors.
My Cambridge leather sofa is the perfect example. You'd spend thousands at one of those hoity-toity stores for a leather sofa of this quality. At my Bob's, it's only $6.99.
100% genuine leather, extremely stately, incredibly comfortable, and ridiculously low at only $6.99.
No wonder Bob's discount furniture keeps growing and growing.
Come on down.
What are you doing?
Oh, you'll see, my friend.
Why is everybody talking about Friends?
Monica was getting a boob job.
Things are getting friendlier.
We've never slept with you.
And whose fault is that?
On Friends.
Weeknights on New England CW 56.
No doubt, it is a dangerous stunt that could kill somebody. They call it ghost riding, and it takes reckless driving to a disturbing level. The Night Team's Lauren Prisbel with a terrifying new trend.
Ghost riding. Some call it a thrill, an adrenaline rush, but police call it a dangerous stunt. Leaving a car in gear or in neutral while it's still moving, then dancing next to it on the hood, the roof, or the trunk before getting back behind the wheel. Sometimes things go wrong.
To leave a vehicle completely uncontrolled and to just trust it to nature, if you will, and the forces of nature and physics, is taken foolish to new heights.
25-year-old Vip Paddle, who lives in Northern California, says he started ghost riding about 6 months ago.
Saw people doing it, thought it was funny, and wanted to try it.
His buddies videotaped the ride, then he posted it on MySpace. He's hooked.
The thrill just doing it and, you know, taking the risk, you know, it's dangerous, but you know, it's fun at the same time.
Ghost riding home videos have exploded on internet sites like YouTube, some of them mixed with a popular hip-hop tune that celebrates this risky ride.
Ghost ride the whip, ghost ride the whip.
It is so widespread, police in places like Stockton, California, and San Diego say it's a disturbing trend.
Well, hopefully it's a short fad, but
It's already proven to lead to injuries and death.
Like this video we showed earlier, the driver bails before his truck hits a fire hydrant and crashes into an electric pole. He was lucky. But in Stockton, police say 18-year-old Davinder Gully was killed while performing a stunt out the window of his SUV. Patel says he only pushes his luck so far.
Make sure you do it in a controlled environment and just keep it safe and don't do anything out of control.
But police warned that without anyone behind the wheel, everything is already out of control.
Police in some cities say they used to see a lot of illegal drag racing at night. Now they are breaking up late night car rallies where ghost riding is being done. Live in the newsroom, I'm Lauren Prisbel, 7 News 19.
And police in South Florida are searching for a creative criminal with an eye for a nice pair of slacks. Over the past few months, a bandit has been stealing people's pants in public and at gunpoint. One man was shot after he refused to turn over his trousers to a man in a car. But another victim, who was held up on foot just yesterday, wasn't willing to take that chance.
Gave my pants and my drawers. And he took my shoes too. It's embarrassing. You know, you got cars around by, seeing you naked, they blowing their horn at you.
Oh no, that man also lost his wallet with his shorts. Police say it's a quick way for criminals to take off with all the valuables a person has on them.
And now, time for 7 Sports with Dave Gwynn.
Timing is everything, and it's certainly one thing that played right into the Jets' hands last time. Eric Mangini had tons of it, 2 weeks' time to prepare for the Patriots. The result was no time for Tom Brady. Remember, number 12, he was slammed on that once nasty Gillette Stadium turf on numerous occasions. The Jets sacked Brady 4 times. But like the playing surface, time has healed the Pats' offense. They're now stretching the field and not looking back.
How we played 8 weeks ago has zero bearing on this game. I mean, I can't overstate that enough. It has so little to do. We're a totally different team at this point. You just realize that if you don't play your best, then you got a great chance of being beat. Why? Because you're playing against teams that are the best in the league, and your margin of error is that much more slim.
The face, or rather the scowl, of the Pittsburgh Steelers is stepping down after 15 years. Bill Cowher today resigning to spend more time with his family. Cowher Steelers went 8-8 this season, just a year removed from winning the Super Bowl. Pittsburgh has had only 2 coaches since 1969, but they, like the Oakland Raiders who fired Art Schell today, will start their next search immediately. The Celtics in Memphis tonight, but more than anything, they're kind of stuck in an identity crisis. Just 11 wins, they're just a few losses from the league's worst record and a shot at Greg Oden in next year's draft. On the other hand, though, the Greens string together a few W's, they could actually find themselves in first place. Yes, they're just 2 games out. Gotta love the Atlantic. Second quarter, look at this. Gorgeous. Second quarter, Sebastian Telfair alley-ooped to Gerald Green. Worth another look. Beauty, Green impressing with Pierce out. Celtics not faring well here, though. Ryan Gomes, meet Alexander Johnson. He swats that ball, I think, back into the second deck. Fourth quarter, though, Tony Allen learning what he can do best, and that is go to the rack. The great dunk there. 20 points on the night for Tony. Celtics up a dozen. Sign, things are going well. Well, that's Brian Scalabrine just gunning. Had a couple of threes, 4 for 4 from three-point range, in fact. Season high, 16 points. Season high for the Celtics, 128 points as they beat the Grizzlies. To the ice now, a great sight for the Bruins fans. Rookie center Phil Kessel back on the ice tonight, less than a month after undergoing surgery for testicular cancer. How about that? Kessel joining the Providence Bruins for a game against Worcester. He did not score in the Baby Bees 2-1 loss, but that is a great sign nonetheless. Kessel set to rejoin the big club on Monday.
Time for the play of the day, the Mass State Lottery winning combination.
Well, that we take you to Edmonton last night during the wee hours. The Dallas Stars up 5-4 on the Oilers. Seconds to go in regulation. Patrick Steffen just missed an empty netter. Yes, the net was empty. He missed other end. You guessed it. Goal ties the game at 5. But the Stars did save some face, winning this game in a shootout. Worth another look there. It's a big Saturday over on 7. Chiefs and Colts at 4:30. Cowboys, Seahawks to follow at 8. And then we'll be here to wrap it up on the 56 at 10. got all those numbers, guys, I think we got it right.
We'll be watching. Thanks, Dave.
A lot on your plate. Well, the Red Sox shelled out some big bucks to bring Daisuke Matsuzaka to town.
And now the team is taking steps to reel in tourists, too. The Herald is reporting that the Sox have hired a New York marketing firm to help cash in on Japanese tourist dollars. The firm is headed by Christine Nicholas, a former aide to ex-New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani. She was in charge when the Yankees brought in a Japanese import of their own, slugger Hideki Matsui.
Down to make that money back. Still to come here from the night team, making pudgy pooches a thing of the past, a new drug designed to melt away the inches.
Can your car seat handle its precious cargo? What you need to know before you strap in your infant.
Okay, talking trash time. One city's unusual approach to collecting trash bills and why residents say it stinks.
First prescription weight loss drug aimed at treating plump pooches is approved. The Food and Drug Administration says the drug called Pfizer's Slentrol helps decrease appetite and fat absorption. But the liquid medicine can also cause various side effects. Roughly 5% of the nation's dogs are considered obese. Another 20 to 30% are overweight.
It is unsettling information for you parents out there. New tests on child car seats have revealed some troubling flaws.
In a crash, they can mean the difference between survival or death. Child car seats cut the risk of injury or death by 71%. But now Consumer Reports says its new, tougher crash tests may show infant car seats on the market might not be good enough.
We found that many of the infant seats on the market are deficient in providing side impact protection and protection at higher crash speeds than what the government requires.
9 of the 12 infant car seats tested by Consumer Reports performed poorly. Among them, the Evenflow Discovery. On the video, it flew off its base. The Eddie Bauer Comfort Seat, which technicians couldn't fit properly in any of 5 cars. Also the Graco Safe Seat and the Bretax Companion, which jumped off the seat and then slammed back again.
We are asking the government to recall the Evenflow Discovery and the Eddie Bauer Comfort.
The maker of the Eddie Bauer model says it's already making a newly designed base for its car seats, which meets or exceeds federal requirements. And Evenflow CEO insists his car seat has successfully passed more than 200 tests.
We steadfastly stand behind the safety of all of our car seats, including Discovery.
And the car seat industry makes issue with Consumer Reports methodology, running the frontal tests at 35 miles per hour, not 30 like the government tests, and adding a side impact crash of 38 miles per hour. They're the same speeds new cars are crash tested as well. Both Graco and Bretax say their seats meet or exceed government standards. Meantime, 2 seats did get the approval of Consumer Reports, the Graco Snug Ride with EPS and the Baby Trend Flex Lock. The advice from the experts, no child should ever go without a car seat that's properly secured.
If the car seat comes loose or moves more than it should in a crash, or the child is ejected because the harness straps are not on properly, the child could be seriously injured or killed.
And experts say whatever you do, don't decide not to put your child in a car seat.
Being the parent of a little one, it makes you think the government needs to do more thorough testing because Consumer Reports did this.
And it can get confusing, too, out there as a consumer.
Right. Coming up, talking trash and Braintree, the unusual steps one town is taking when customers don't cough up the cash.
The Globe was always in my house. My father and I used to sit on his bed every Sunday and read through the Sunday paper.
Get Boston's Sunday Globe home delivery, just $1.75 per week for 12 weeks.
The Globe helps me feel like I'm a part of Boston.
My favorite section to read in the Boston Globe is definitely the sports section.
Keeps in the forefront of what's happening politically.
I use the Boston Globe to plan my weekends. There's a life to the city. There's a vivacity reflected in the Boston Globe.
It's like a good book that you can't put down.
You're going to find out what's really going on.
Call 1-800-258-3999. And you'll get local coverage of news, people, sports, and events.
I like the Globe South. I know what's going on in my neck of the woods.
I can have a different flavor of the different towns.
North Shore.
South Shore.
Cambridge.
The South End.
Jamaica Plain.
I wouldn't live anywhere else.
Call 1-800-258-3993 for Sunday home delivery and get 12 weeks for $175 per week, a 50% savings.
It's the best feeling in the world on a Sunday morning to wake up and know that the Globe is right outside my door.
You know what I don't understand?
What?
Tipping. I mean, 18%, it's outrageous. Why do I have to pay someone else's employee for them?
Tell me about it. Look, someone gives me good service, I leave 10%, tops.
And how about birthday gifts?
Oh.
If someone is over 12, they're not getting one from me.
Me neither.
Doormen?
Stiff them.
Our most popular paper products at new, low prices every day. So you can pay less at the place you've always liked to shop. Stop and Shop.
With one click, you can build your new Toyota. Select the options. Choose the accessories. Get a quote. A rate for financing. Even compare features to the competition. Buyatoyota.com. Our showroom. At your fingertips. Toyota, moving forward.
What do you say to people who are dangerously bipolar and painfully uptight?
Everyone's so old, there isn't a neck here you couldn't jump rope with.
You say, don't change a thing.
Surprise!
Will and Grace, all week long.
Weeknights at 6:30 on CW 56.
It's all about the trash talk in 110 tonight. They have started a unique way of letting people know they need to pay their bills.
The night team's Grant Greenberg has the story from Braintree.
Trash collectors make stop after stop picking up trash in Braintree. But they won't be stopping at this house, owned by Colleen McDonald.
We were being scarlet lettered, so to speak.
Three letters to be exact, NTS, no trash service, to let garbage men know that she didn't pay her trash fee.
I think it's very humiliating. I think it's very unfair.
Thing is, McDonald moved out of this home more than a year ago and pays her trash fees on the two other homes she owns in Braintree, so she doesn't think she should have to pay the trash fee here.
The trash fees aren't even generated from there because there's no trash, so it's very, very unfair.
So they wanted you to pay for something that you weren't even using?
Absolutely.
So far, only about three homes in Braintree have the letters NTS painted in front of them. Trash collectors say that number should grow.
These are the list of people that didn't pay.
A list is one thing, but letters in front of a house, that's strong mixed reaction from the community.
It is pretty embarrassing.
If one of us have to pay, we should all have to be fair as fair.
Colleen McDonald doesn't think Braintree is being fair. She says she's gone back and forth about this issue and wants the letters gone.
I think it's a pointless way to get things done.
I did try contacting the public works director several times. I called him, went to his office. He didn't return any of my messages. I did speak with two town selectmen. They tell me that they do support the public works department, that people do need to pay, although some are concerned this may be going a bit too far. We're in Braintree, Grant Greenberg, 7 News 19.
Still to come here from the 19.
A sea lion left high and dry, how it's getting a helping hand. Stay with us.
Big report?
On Shakespeare, but I have 6 weeks.
Yeah, I'll give myself 6 weeks too. Help lower my cholesterol.
Good luck with your cholesterol.
Good luck with your report.
How's that report coming?
Fine.
Tomorrow's a big day, huh?
I'm working on it.
Still?
You had it easy. You ate Cheerios for 6 weeks. I had to write a report.
Help lower your cholesterol 4% in just 6 weeks. Cheerios. Now's the time.
It's almost over. Shreve Crump and Lowe's spectacular reorganization sale. There's still a gigantic selection remaining. Shreve's must dispose of all this inventory immediately. We've taken even greater reductions one final time. Diamonds, precious gems, fine jewelry, and giftware are now 40 to 60% off original ticketed prices. Save on famous brand Swiss watches, too. Now 30 to 40% off. Don't miss this opportunity to take advantage of Shreve's final reductions. This is one sale you can't afford to miss.
It's striking in appearance. It offers exhilaration. Its fuel efficiency lets you go beyond. Safety is a priority. And dependability has long been synonymous with its name. The Toyota Camry. Exceptional may even be an understatement. Ask someone you know who drives one.
Save 65% on a beautiful selection of furs, including mink, fox, beaver, fur trim, leather, and more during our one-day fur sale in the Fur Vault, available at Macy's.
What are you doing?
Oh, you'll see, my friend.
Why is everybody talking?
Kids say all kinds of crap.
About friends.
I'm gonna be on TV.
Here's a hint.
Monica was getting a boob job.
Things are getting friendlier.
We've never slept with you.
But whose fault is that?
On Friends. Weeknights on New England CW 56.
The young California sea lion is settling into his new home today. He had quite a scare, though, after getting stranded on a San Diego beach. Apparently, a high tide gave the six-month-old pup a little too much of a boost to shore. He was rescued by the folks at SeaWorld, who will take care of him for the next 4 to 6 weeks. And I can imagine take care of him and spoil him as well.
Oh, it's good he was discovered, that somebody found him. So cute.
Oh, adorable up there. Have a great weekend. That does it for us tonight. I'm Francis Griffin.
And I'm Matt Lorch. The news just getting started over on Channel 7. Have a great night.
This Monday on the new CW, the new VCR,
a Betamax,
is really bringing Chris's family together.
Cartoons? Who recorded cartoons over my young and the rest?
Everybody hates Chris. Then, a new girlfriend's secret is exposed.
She's a dancer and straddles strange men for money.
Not all of them are strange. Some of them are your friends.
All of us, after Everybody Hates Chris, this Monday, starting at 8, 7 central on the new CW.
Do you have a...